To those that are new, welcome. And to those that are coming back, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Miss K here. We are going to continue with talking about trigonometry. In the previous video, we spoke about methods that are useful when we have to solve problems involving triangles. When you talk about trigonometry, we are actually just talking about calculations that have to do with triangles, that being whether we are finding a side, meaning the length of a side, or perhaps you want to know the size of an angle inside a triangle. We have spoken about all the properties that we needed in the previous video. If you haven't watched it, please watch it before you continue with this one. And we have also spoken about methods that are useful. These calculations will actually be determined by the information that is provided to you, as well as what you are asked to find. So in this video, we are focusing on examples that actually involves those methods that we have spoken about in the previous video. The very first thing we are going to look at is when you are given two sides and you have to find the third side. So in the previous video, we spoke about the Pythagoras theorem, and this is what the method that we are going to be using, that when we are given two sides and we have to find the third side. For instance, triangle ABC, we used the Pythagoras theorem says that the longer side, which we call the hypotenuse, which I'm going to abbreviate hype, and remember, it's always in a right angled triangle that you are able to use the Pythagoras theorem, only in a right angled triangle. So what we're going to do is the longer side squared, BC squared, is equal to AB squared, which means the shorter side squared. These two sides are considered or referred to as the shorter sides. So if I square this side and I add this side squared, I'll be able to get this side squared. So this is the formula so that I'm going to use. But if you want to find any of the other sides, which means any of the two shorter sides, you're always going to subtract from the longer side. So if you have to find any of the two from this, and you're given this and one of the two, you're going to have to subtract the shorter side squared, take it out of the longer side squared if you have to find this one. Or perhaps this one squared minus that one squared if you have to find this one. Okay, having said that, that takes us to some examples. So I'm going to give just one example to just to use the Pythagoras theorem, one where we are finding one of the shorter sides and one where we are finding the longer side, so that we just see how we actually apply what we call this Pythagoras theorem or theorem of Pythagoras. In the first example, I do hope that you are able to see that. We are asked to find the length of the side marked X. So we have to find this side, and we are given this side and that side. So remember, this side will be our hypotenuse, meaning our longer side, and this side will be one of the shorter sides. So basically, we are looking for a shorter side. If we want, we could label this A, B, C the way we want, and then we write our formula. But if we want, we could also just take note of the fact that we know, when we know the longer side and one of the shorter sides, we are going to take X squared, the shorter side squared, will give us the longer side squared minus the other shorter side squared. We know from solving your equations, if we want to get rid of the square, we know that when we have to get rid of the square, we have to square root. Excuse the closeness, ne? My bad. So X will be equal to 25, because 5 squared is 25, minus 16. Remember, I have a square root. We do know from our basics that when we square root, we know it's positive or negative. But however, we're not going to consider that, because this is distance. We're finding length. Length can never be a negative. So we are going to totally ignore the fact that it's supposed to be positive or negative. So this is going to be square root of 9. Therefore, X is equal to 3 centimeters. And we are done. So what do we do when we have to find one of the longer side squared? I mean, one of the shorter side squared, we are going to have to subtract from the longer side. So that is how you do that. So I'm going to give you example two, where we're going to be finding the longer side instead.
In the second example, we are solving for x, this the side marked with x. Remember, as long as it's the right angled triangle and we have two sides and we want the third side, we are going to use the Pythagoras theorem. So since it's the longer side that we are looking for, we are going to say x squared is equal to 8 squared plus 6 squared. That is, x squared is equal to 64 plus 36. So x squared will be equal to 100. Then we square root, then we know that x will be equal to 10 centimeters. So the length of this side will have to be 10 centimeters. Okay. So that is how we use the Pythagoras theorem. And when do we use the Pythagoras theorem? When we have two sides and we want the third side. It has to do with distance. We don't ever think about the Pythagoras theorem if there's any angle involved. We only think about the Pythagoras theorem or make use of the Pythagoras theorem when we have two sides and we want the third side. Okay, so please do take note of that.